SummerSlam several years ago, when you take what Brock did to those guys, and then you say, let's throw Finn Balor to him, what do you think legitimately and realistically is going to happen to Finn Balor? Exactly. But again, this is where the hardcore wrestling fan base comes into play. You see, they are so passionate about professional wrestling as a sport, not just sports entertainment, but as a sport, that they feel Finn Balor against Brock Lesnar, despite the size disparity, despite the weight disparity, that Finn Balor and Brock Lesnar can be a great professional wrestling athletic contest. That it could be the classic David versus Goliath storyline, and it could deliver, and the result in their eyes, the delivered result in their eyes could be a 5-star professional wrestling athletic contest. That's why fans were cheering for Finn Balor, because the hardcore fans, whether they admit it or not, want that classic David versus Goliath matchup that they feel could give them a 5-star athletically based professional wrestling match between two men like Brock Lesnar and Finn Balor. They basically feel that they can get a hybrid of both that professional wrestling strong style of Japan against that MMA style that Brock Lesnar has in his background, in his repertoire, I should say, easy for me to say. But Brock Lesnar has it in his repertoire. So that's why fans want it. They want, because they believe those two, despite the weight difference, the size difference, can put on a great athletic David versus Goliath professional wrestling mat classic. And again, this goes back to what I've said numerous times, and I'll say it again. Nowadays, the professional wrestling business, some promotions, major indie promotions, minor indie promotions, minor promotions, international promotions, internationally independent promotions, you name it. Small indie promotions, small promotions. This is why nowadays that all these promotions, major independents like Ring of Honor, PWG, CZW, minor promotions, semi-major promotions, as you say, like Impact Wrestling, and so on and so forth. World of Sport Wrestling in Japan. Even New Japan itself, in a sense. Maybe not as much. But the reason the hardcore fans are like they are today is because of that influence that the professional wrestling business, those promotions that I've mentioned, have had on them because of the influence that mixed martial arts, the artistic style and grandeur of mixed martial arts has had on those promotions that I've mentioned. Why do you think Ring of Honor has matches where a lot of people say it takes up to 20 minutes, 30 minutes, 15 minutes before you get the first fall? And then the final fall comes maybe, 30 minutes later. Because Ring of Honor is heavily influenced by MMA. Same with PWG. Same with some of the promotions I've mentioned. And this has influenced the fans to want that same kind of grandeur, mixed martial arts style-like atmosphere in professional wrestling. That's why fans, hardcore fans especially, whether it's after a pay-per-view or it's just a certain town and city WWE's in, this is why they hijack the show and say, we want this. Because they want what they feel is the best given opportunity to become a reality. That's why hardcore fans chanted for Finn Balor to be Brock's opponent. Because they feel, like I said, it's that classic David versus Goliath motif that would present itself in a hybrid-like style meshes that MMA style background that Brock has with that New Japan Strong style that Finn Balor has. And they feel that that would make an instant match classic. And that would, they feel that would result in an athletically professional wrestling match classic. By believing that would be the case, they're not looking at it from a realistic, legitimate standpoint that Jeff Siegel's trying to point out. And that legitimate standpoint is, in reality, Brock Lesnar could basically destroy someone like Finn Balor. That's what he's looking at. And yet fans persist on this matchup in his eyes. And in Jeff's eyes, from Jeff's perspective, and in Jeff's perspective, in his own opinion, basically, you know, fans are blinded to that fact. Blinded to the stupidity and the absurdity of this match being a reality. And I think that's the point Jeff's trying to get across, is you can dream it, you can fantasize it, you can play it on your 2K17 game, but it's not going to happen in real life. WWE is not going to do that. Because like I said, it's like putting me, the Lex Man, Jeff Siegel, Chase Oliver, in a 4-on-1 situation against Brock, and we wouldn't stand a chance. Each of us would be beaten to pulp one by one within the span of maybe 5 minutes. Or maybe 10 minutes or less. And the way Jeff looks at it is fans expect Finn Balor to stand a chance. No way. So to close out this subject, I agree with Jeff. I agree with Jeff's opinion. But like I said, you got to look at what time and what era and what time frame we're in now, and how heavily influenced a lot of indie wrestling, and if not international wrestling promotions, have become or been influenced by that MMA style like atmosphere and grandeur, and how it's influenced the fans as well, because they want that same kind of grandeur and atmosphere that they've seen get influenced by MMA onto the promotions that I've mentioned, the indie, the major and minor and small independent promotions and international promotions. They want that same presence in WWE, and that's why they want Balor against Lesnar. Even though they don't see the reality and illogicness behind said matchup, if you catch my drift. But that's all I'm going to say on that. Now, let's get to the last thing here. And I do apologize for this going into two being... I do apologize for this being in two parts, this being the second part that I'm talking this last subject in, and that's Roman Reigns' nuclear heat. What can I say? You want to talk about nuclear heat that Roman Reigns has, and how fans feel about Roman Reigns being the one chosen to go over The Undertaker and potentially and realistically The Undertaker's last match before retiring at WrestleMania this past Sunday. Let me give you an example of how nuclear Roman's heat is, and how nuclear the kind of heat WWE is receiving as a result of that. There are fans that have gone on to change.org, the petition site, and have created a petition asking, if not demanding, that WWE expunge The Undertaker's WrestleMania 33 loss. Yeah. You have fans that have created a petition at change.org to expunge, to have the WWE expunge, wipe out of existence Undertaker's WrestleMania 33 loss to Roman Reigns. And you know what's funny is you have a lot of fans that may be upset about it and may not like the fact that Roman was chosen to go over Undertaker in his last match. But even they find the absurdity, easy for me to say, of this petition being made. It's absurd. The absurdity in their minds of fans going out and making this petition on change.org is stupid. Yes, they agree that Roman Reigns shouldn't have gone over The Undertaker. They do agree. But they're also sensible enough to realize just because you may not agree with the decision that was probably made well in advance at WrestleMania, or for WrestleMania, for that matchup, that to go this far and say, hey, let's create this petition, have WWE, and petition WWE to wipe out that loss, is stupid. I mean, look, there's no doubt Roman's going to get a lot of nuclear heat out of this. I mean, you saw this past Monday exactly what kind of nuclear heat this guy's got. I mean, Deluxe Man did a freaking reaction to it at the end of his Raw recap. And he watched every second of it, commentated on it. And he acknowledged how for about 5 minutes, fans in the Amory Arena, originally the Orlando Arena, were chanting, "Thank you, Taker." And then how that slowly morphed from "Thank you, Taker" to "Roman sucks." And how when Roman came out, not only did he get massively booed by that crowd at the Amory Arena, and probably millions watching at home, but you have fans chanting, "Roman sucks, Roman sucks." You have them chanting in tune to the New Day instrumental, "Roman sucks, Roman sucks, Roman sucks," in the tune of New Day's music, or in the beat to the beat of New Day's music. And if that's not enough, you have him chanting to Roman something you haven't heard in WWE for a long time on television. "Shut the beep up. Shut the up. Shut the up." They were telling him to shut the... Excuse my language, God. They were telling Roman to shut the fuck up. Excuse my language, God. But that's what they were saying. And then they were telling him, "Asshole. Asshole. Asshole." And when is the last time you ever seen a supposed babyface be told to shut the F up and be called an asshole? Not that I remember. Or how about this one? "Go away. Go away. Go away." When is the last time a babyface, or any wrestler, heel or babyface, got that kind of reaction where, as to quote Deluxe Man, fans are basically telling him, "Get out of our lives. We don't want to see you again. We don't care if you get injured. Hey, we'd be glad you get injured to get you off our television and out of our sights." Never really once. I mean, yeah, you had Vince McMahon being called all sorts of names and being told this and that, and so same with Stephanie, same with Vicky Guerrero, same with X-Pac, Sean Waltman, but never to this degree. And yeah, some people will make up the excuse and say, well, it's the Raw after WrestleMania crowd. Of course they're going to be rambunctious. Of course they're going to be vocal and vulgar at times. And that's true. But not to this extent. Especially to one guy. I mean, I'll be honest with you. When the streak ended, yeah, Brock got booed, but it wasn't to this extent. It wasn't to this extent whatsoever. So, for Roman to get this kind of heat, nuclear heat, as a lot of people on social media, Twitter, Facebook, RingsideNews.com, Pro Wrestling Illustrated, Cage Side Seats, you know, YouTube itself, the RCWR show, Don Tony, Kevin Castle, Jason Solomonster, the Solomonster Sounds Off, and even OTR Central, Deluxe Man, Chase Oliver, you name it. Everyone that's talked about the reaction fans gave Roman Reigns. I'm sure AfterBuzz TV did the same thing. The reaction that Roman Reigns got, everybody has used two words. Nuclear heat. In other words, you could power the freaking nuclear missiles that people say Korea wants to launch. With the kind of heat that Roman Reigns got. That's right, you could, Korea, if they wanted to, and they've always put fear into people's eyes of when, of not if, but when they'll ever do it. When you look at the power that's needed to fuel, to power up such a device of mass destruction, in a comparison kind of way, that's the kind of power, that's the kind of nuclear power, nuclear heat that Roman Reigns got. The kind that can freaking power up a missile and launch it. That is the kind of nuclear heat Roman Reigns got. And for WWE to be persistent about pushing him as a babyface, I don't know. I mean, let's look logically at something. When Hulk Hogan went to WCW, he was pushed as the babyface he always had been. They tried to recreate a lot of scenarios to familiarize that southern audience who was familiar with Hulk Hogan and WWF. They tried to create scenarios and storylines similar to what he had up in Connecticut. But when the fans started to turn against him because of the ridiculousness and absurdity, I know I'm using that word a lot, and I do apologize, that in direction that these storylines were going in with the Dungeon of Doom, and the Four Horsemen, and whoever. And Hogan himself was getting booed out of the building by the fans. Even Hogan knew it was time to make a change. And when Hogan realized, okay, these people want to turn against me, instead of embracing it for as long as he did, because when they started turning on him, he still kind of remained the way he was, but when he saw the NWO gold mine in front of him, he basically looked at that and said, you know what? The fans want to boo me